China signs major railroad deal with Uzbekistan and Kyrgyzstan, bypassing Russia.
Here's a summary of the article.
China, Kyrgyzstan and Uzbekistan have signed a long-anticipated agreement to push ahead with the construction of a railroad linking their countries that will, if completed, establish a shorter route to Europe, bypassing sanctions hit Russia. It does move the project one step closer to reality, by laying out terms for a feasibility study for the Kyrgyz leg, which is the missing link to connect existing railroads in China and Uzbekistan, to be completed by the first half of 2023. Kyrgyzstan had pushed for a route that would serve more populated areas further north but appears to have settled on a route restricted to the south, from which it will reap benefits, from job creation for construction of the line and transit fees. The railroad will begin at Torugart, where there is an existing road crossing from China, and continue north through the settlements of Arpa and Makhmul to Jalalabad, where it will link up with Uzbekistan's rail network. China will also need to build 160 kilometers of track to feed into the new line, according to The Economist. That would shorten the route from China to Europe by 900 kilometers and cut 8 days off the travel time, The Economist calculated. A project it sees as part of a grand scheme to improve transport and trade links westward from Central Asia to Turkey and onward to Europe, on a route that bypasses internationally isolated Russia.
This post received a score of 40,000, with an upvote ratio of 94%. Here are the top comments in response to this article.
The Belt and Road taking its effect.
Fucking belters, am I right?
Fuck the Inyalauta.
Geographically speaking, why would they go through Russia in the first place?
Basically because it's flatter, the southern route has several mountains to cross. There's a Beijing-Irkutsk rail where it can transfer to the Trans-Siberia if I'm not mistaken.
You are correct. There's also a route through Mongolia, though IIRC it's not all train and there's a connecting bus.
It is all train.
Train all the way down.
It's almost like the Chinese government has realized the Russians are pretty unreliable as an ally or something.
The fix is in Russia will lose the war and relations are never gonna normalize with the West ever again. China is acting accordingly.
China, like every other country, cares about their own interests. They'll take the path that most benefits them in general. I imagine supporting Russia is not in their best interest due to global sentiment and the way the war is going, so they won't do so.
The Chinese government didn't even bother to give Russia good PR domestically this time. Half the population sides with Ukraine, and supports their defensive war and counterattack. I really think Beijing is none too pleased with Russia's moronic decision and is doing the bare minimum to keep up appearances and relations at this point. The Chinese government, known for its less than stellar approaches to censorship, has not censored any pro-Ukrainian comments.
China is pissed that Russia helped unify the West against aggression on weaker countries. Exactly the kind of thing that will forever cock-block their move for invading Taiwan.
It's more that Russia's actions directly goes against China's policy on sovereignty. If China supported Russia at all, it would mean going against their own words when it comes to their reunification campaign with Taiwan.
Yay, makes sense they would do the opposite to that of their claim.
I mean, to be fair, China's default response to Russia doing anything is to show support. Sentiments regarding Russia 1 month into the conflict and 6 months in the conflict are different, as people learn what's going on. Western media sites only show Ukrainian perspective of the war, Russian media only shows the Russian perspective. Generally speaking, comments on the Russian videos are likely to be pro-Russian and comments on the Ukrainian side are likely to be pro-Ukrainian.
This is a misleading title. This was planned 25 years ago originally and it's just something they formally signed recently. The title makes it seem like it's a slight on Russia, which it isn't. May as well say it bypasses India as well.
This video was automatically created by Reddit to speech. The article and comments in this video were selected from Reddit according to their upvotes. And any paraphrasing was performed by smmry.com, without any human intervention.